Hi there, I'm Andrew Dodds from SimpleStack. We help companies build tools on Airtable and other no-code applications to automate the mundane work and focus on what really matters. Today, we're going to be taking a look at how you can use AI in Airtable for any of the documents that you may be uploading, contracts or other agreements where you want to extract key terms or maybe analyze the contracts. All of that is possible with AI in Airtable. So if that sounds interesting to you, let's get into it. So I'm over here in my Airtable base. We're gonna be using just a single table called contracts. I've got the contract name, and then I have created an attachment field here where we will be able to drop contracts into this attachment field. For the first use case, we're gonna look at two different ones. For the first use case, I want AI to analyze the risks in a contract that we may be thinking about signing with a prospective company. Okay, so in order to do that, I'm going to create a field by clicking on this plus. I'm going to go to the long text field, and you'll see it's got a little star by it. That's because you can use AI on a field like this. We're going to say we want to generate values with AI. I'm going to give this a field name of risks, and we can decide whether or not it's going to generate automatically or we have to push a button. For now, I'm going to set it to generate automatically once we upload our contract. Okay, and then we can give it instructions. You can reference fields, which we're going to be doing for the contract copy field, by putting it in curly braces like this, as you can see here. Okay, so I'm going to give it a prompt. It's going to be really simple. And we'll go ahead and see how this goes. So I'm going to say, you are a legal contract reviewer, specifically trained in finding and analyzing potential risks within a contract. Reference. And we're going to use the curly braces to say this. So it's going to look at the attachment. Reference this and output the top three concerns or risk considerations. So this is a pretty simple prompt. And I'll go ahead and create this field. Now you'll notice that we get a note here that says required fields are empty or unavailable. That means you don't yet have a contract that you've uploaded and you've set it to generate automatically. So what we're going to do is upload a contract. I've got one here. And we'll go ahead and upload that. And then you'll see that it changes to generating. And so it's thinking here. Let's spread this out so you can see it a little better. And it's going to come up with the top three risks. It's still going through its process, and here we go. Now, within Airtable, I can expand a cell by clicking this. It'll give me this little box here where I can see everything now. Great, so it's basically saying there's a termination for convenience clause, there's an intellectual property clause that lacks clarity or ownership, and the limitation of liability includes indirect incidental, which limits recourse. So you'll see that if we actually look at the contract itself, it was able to go through and pull all of that based on this. This is 4 pages. So imagine, you know, with a more realistic one, it may be 10 pages, 20 pages. And you can cut down the work that it takes in order to take, you know, to figure out like what the contract risk may be. Another really cool thing that I want to show you here is it cites its work, its sources. It's not readily apparent, but what you can do is you can click on these check marks here to view sources. This is really cool. Where did it come from within the contract? So when we do this, we launch and you'll see that its first risk came from this specific highlight. And you can see it here. I can click on, okay, show me where the second risk that you came up with comes from. It'll jump down to that highlighted area. So this is a great way to be able to check the work, right? Because AI may not always give you the best answer, but you'll be able to check your work here to make sure that it all makes sense, and it can do a lot of that heavy initial work for you, that heavy lifting. So this is one way to use an AI field in Airtable to extract data from a document. Another use case that I want us to go through is a costing use case. So we'll pretend that we are accounts payable and that we need to take out data about payments that we're going to have to make to this vendor into a field where we don't have to click into the document to figure out when the payments are going to be or what the payments are for. And we want to be able to see that in a field right away. So I'll show you that now. We'll create a way to do that. Going to create another AI field here. This is going to be long text. I'm going to call this payments. We're going to generate values with AI. This time we won't generate automatically. We'll have the user has to click a button in order to extract that information. And let's go ahead with the prompt. You are an accounts payable accountant, and you will scan this document. Remember, we're going to reference that document that we've uploaded, the contract copy, to find the payment information and total payment amount. Okay, let's go ahead and try that. It's a really simple prompt. Now we can make this a lot more complex if we wanted to bring it out in certain formats or, all of those kind of things to limit what it shows us. But I want to just show you out of the box how easy it can even be. So we'll create this field, and you'll see that this one gives us a little button to press. So I'm going to press on generate, and this will pull out those line items that we saw. The total payment amount is 16,000, and payments are due within 30 days of the invoice unless otherwise agreed to in writing. So this gave us a little bit of context on how the payments are going to be made. Now, if we wanted to be able to see the line items here, we could change this slightly. We could say your accounts payable, find the total amount, also include the line item names and amounts. Okay, so we'll save that. When you change the prompt and you have old information, you're going to refresh it to generate a new value. Late payments may incur. Payments are due within 30%. Late payments may incur 1.5% per month. Total payment amount is 16,000. So you see, even with the revise, and this is sort of where AI comes into play, right? And where you have to work on your prompting. Even with the way that I revised it, it still didn't pull out the line item amounts. And so we need to be a little more explicit. So I'm going to say you are an accounts payable accountant, and you're going to scan this document to find each item and its amount, as well as the total contract amount. And we'll even give it a formatting step here to be extra clear. Format like this. And we're going to say item one, amount. Item two, amount. And then total amount. So let's see if we can get it with this one. We'll refresh that. There you go. And you'll see that even though I prompted it as item one and item two, it understood that that meant in the contract, those are called item A and item B. We've now got a much easier way to read this. And as the accounts payable person, if I wanted to see the cited sources, I can click on the cited sources, and you'll see that we've got our table here that that information is coming from. All right, so that is all we had for today. If you got value from this, feel free to like and subscribe. We've got lots of Airtable content that comes out weekly. If you need help with something you're building or have got some questions, we can help you out with that as well. Feel free to follow the links in the bio. And I'll see you next week.